Hi everyone, I am Dr Mallinath, senior orthopedic surgeon working in Bangalore. I am expert in joint replacement, both hip and knee surgeries, keyhole surgeries like arthroscopic surgery, minimally invasive orthopedic surgery and complex trauma management.
Thanks for coming. Today we are planning to take this basic information of TKR, which is also called as total knee joint replacement, which is I think most common surgery that is being performed in orthopedics.
It is just a replacement of the cartilage of the knee joint. It is also called a knee arthroplasty. It is like a simple dental procedure. In the dental procedure, what they do for the care is just they remove the damaged part of the tooth and they make a small drill hole in the tooth and they fill the cement and after that they put a case of the tooth. In the total knee replacement, what we do is keeping all the structures including the surrounding ligaments and bone intact. Only the damaged cartilage is removed with a specialized equipment and fitted with a metal cap. For this, selection of the patient is very very important. The requirement is the patient has to have a severe arthritis and he should be suffering from the pain since a long duration and he should try all the treatment modalities before deciding about the knee replacement surgery. Lifestyle modification and exercises, medications, injections. In the lifestyle modification, they have to avoid some painful activities. They have to avoid squatting, stair climbing, weight reduction, and they can take some painkiller tablets. And there are some many injections are there for the knee joint if they got the pain. And physiotherapy, supporting kneecap or walking stick. If there is no improvement with all these non-surgical interim methods, then we have to consider for the total knee replacement. The ideal age for the total knee replacement is above 60-70. Older the patient is the better, but he should be fit both mentally and physically. He should be able to walk after the surgery. Diabetes and hypertension are not a contraindication for the total knee replacement. We can do the surgery after controlling these medical conditions. After surgery, nowadays patients can walk on the same day or on the next day. Some patients walk on the same day after 4 to 5 hours after surgery. Some patients walk the next day depending upon their strength and the pain. And they have to stay in the hospital for 4 to 5 days. And after that, they can go home. They have to come back after 10 days for the suture removal. And they have to do regular physiotherapy. Physiotherapy is not that painful. Only for 1 or 2 weeks that physiotherapy is required, but patient has to do himself every day for next 1 or 2 months to get the good range of movements. Otherwise, what happens? Some patients develop stiffness and then that hampers the results of the total knee replacement. Regular walking is recommended after replacement. They have to use a walking stick or walker or cane or crutch for 1-1.5 months and after that they can walk freely. The knee replacement usually lasts for almost 10 to 15 years, not more than that. There are so many different types of knee replacements, but the implant only won't make that all the difference. It makes some difference.
Then what is the difference between the cemented and non-cemented? Okay. Where do we use it? That is
in the knee replacement, it is only cemented knee replacement.
And is there anything related to computer assisted knee joint replacement or?
Still, it is a controversial topic. If the surgeon is good, results are good. It won't make any big differences. Nowadays, we are talking about robotic knee replacement, but still results are not out.
And can we do both surgeries at a single point of
time? We can do both knee replacements in a single stage if required. That my discomfort knee does not require a knee replacement. Only patient has got a severe pain, then it is required. There is one argument that if you do one side replacement, other leg will become short and it will worn out fast. All those things are there, but that is not true actually. Okay. If it is required, you have to undergo the surgery. If patient requires both side knee replacement means, then we have to see the fitness of the patient. Okay. If patient is fit, we can do both side replacement in a single sitting. Okay. It is not technically difficult, but the patient is fit, so we can do it.
If not, he has to wait for
some days, some months, then we can do that.
What the patient has to do?
In the post-operative, after surgery, patient can walk any distance depending upon his strength. He can walk for 1 or 2 kilometers, 3 kilometers, there is no problem. He can, brisk walking is also okay. But high impact activities he has to avoid, like running, and he can drive a two-wheeler car, even he can drive a bicycle also if the person is fit. and he has better to avoid sitting on the floor, squatting, because it is the strength is less in the older age group. They will have difficulty in getting up. Yeah. At that time, they can fall and break their knee joint or other bones. And they must walk. That is the main purpose of the doing knee replacement. At least they have to walk 1 or 2 kilometers. That reduces their weight and controls the sugar, BP, and all the medical problems. Walking is required.
Do you suggest any exercises after surgery to continue throughout his life?
Usually on the post-operative period, we teach them to do some bending exercises and thigh strengthening exercises. Better to continue those exercises for the lifetime. Otherwise, daily they can walk. If they walk for 1 or 2 kilometers, that's enough.
That's it. And he has to undergo TKR at his early age.
Yeah.
And his life of the implant is just 10 to 15 years.
Yeah.
So what is the next remedy? He has to undergo re-surgery or redo surgery?
And after that, we can do a revision replacement. That is, just we have to remove that the metal and put a new one. That is not a very difficult surgery. It can be done anywhere.
Mm-hmm.
And
so the implant for revision surgery is different from...
It is a little bit different. It has got some extension above and below.
Okay.
Those things.
Uh-huh. And what do you say about the cost wise? Because people are also concerned about the cost. The
cost of the revision surgery is a little bit more.
More than
the primary surgery.
Is it the implant cost or the complexity?
It's both. But the implant cost is more.
Okay.
And what happens first, in the first surgery, patient will be fit.
Mm-hmm.
And in the second surgery, he's 10 years or 15 years older, mm-hmm. he'll have more medical problems, all those things.
It's a common practice that people go on taking calcium, thinking that their eroded bone may recover.
Maybe.
There is some hope for a patient to avoid the surgery.
Yeah.
They do all kinds of practices.
They're taking medicines. Yeah.
And they depend on analgesics, though there is less effect at the later stage of erosion.
The calcium tablet does not got any role in the arthritis treatment. It is required for the bone health. Actually, there are only two factors help in the knee joint health. That is the weight and their fitness. They can take simple painkiller tablets once in a week or once in 15 days. Okay, that is no problem. That is not harmful. They start taking daily, means then it is not good, then they can damage their stomach and kidneys, mm-hmm. renal functions. Better to avoid taking long-term painkiller tablets. Better to follow healthy lifestyle, avoid painful activities, do regular exercises, reduce your weight, then definitely you can avoid the replacement. And some patients can use a walking stick, knee stick. That's okay,
nice.
You can manage.
So are there any recent trends that can help us to avoid? Okay.
Only the steroid injections, okay, worldwide, you give steroid injections for the joints, all over the joints it can be given. It reduces the inflammation, reduces the pain, patient will be comfortable. It can be taken. It is not that dangerous. They can take 1 or 2 injections in a year,
mm-hmm.
in specialized centers, reduce the pain definitely. Some patients get relief for 1 or 2 years. There are some artificial lubricant injections are there. They also give some relief to the patient. They can also try, no harm in trying all those things.
Okay.
And coming to this cartilage transplantation, stem cells still in a research phase. We don't know the long-term results.
Sir, for younger patients, are there any options other than directly going for a total knee joint replacement?
High tibial osteotomy or a realignment procedure. You know, knee arthritis, especially in younger age group, is usually because of the bow legs.
Mm-hmm.
Bow legs means their legs are bent like this.
Mm-hmm.
And what happens is because of its bow legs, weight falls on only one side of the knee joint, only half portion of the knee joint is damaged.
Yeah.
This is the pathology in almost majority of the patient. In a high tibial osteotomy realignment, just we have to straighten the leg. Then weight is distributed equally on both half of the knee joint,
okay.
and pain subsides. We have seen patients walking after this surgery for almost 10 to 25 years without any problem. They walk comfortably, they sit on the floor, they squat, they do all the activities. Complication rates are also very
less.
Scientifically, till now, there are only 2 things which are proven to postpone the replacement or to avoid the arthritis. One is a weight reduction, other is a realignment procedure.
Other than symptoms. Symptoms is unbearable pain and
It is clinical, mm-hmm. and there should be radiological confirmation, evidence of the arthritis.
Okay,
that is all.
That's it.